Welcome to another edition of Tribe Sports Today, presented by the Tribe Club. I'm Andrew Phillips, here to look back at an exciting week of Tribe Athletics and look forward to the William & Mary calendar this week, including Family Weekend here at the college. Since we're at Martin Family Stadium, we'll kick things off with the women's soccer team, who moved its unbeaten streak to four matches with a pair of wins last week. Behind two goals apiece from Allie Shaughnessy and Samantha Cordham, the Tribe thumped in-state for Richmond 4-1 on Wednesday night in a game broadcast on NSCAA TV. On Sunday, William & Mary shut out Penn 3-0 and picked up goals from Shaughnessy, freshman Rachel Moore, and junior Katie Johnston. Women's soccer wraps up its two-match road swing at Davidson on Thursday night before returning right here to Martin Family Stadium to host Princeton on Sunday afternoon. The Tigers Tribe women's soccer match will be streamed live for free on Tribe Athletics TV with kickoff starting at 2 p.m. We'll now throw it over to Laurel Jock, who is over at the Millie West Tennis Facility, for more Tribe action.
Thanks, Andrew. Both the men's and women's cross-country teams turned in dominating performances in winning their second events of the year at the William & Mary Invitational on Friday. The men's team placed seven runners among the top nine, winning a perfect score of 15 points. Trevor Slate led the way for William & Mary, winning the event individually. On the women's side, Carolyn Hennessy raced to individual title, while William & Mary put six in the top 10 and finished with a near-perfect score of 17. Field hockey suffered a pair of one-goal losses over the weekend, including a 4-3 overtime setback to number 11 Louisville on Sunday. Pippin Saunders highlighted the Tribe effort with goals in both games during the weekend. Field hockey is back in action this weekend against a pair of nationally ranked opponents. William & Mary hosts number 17 Old Dominion on Friday at 5:30 p.m. before welcoming number 4 Duke to Williamsburg on Sunday afternoon. After dropping a tough pair of five-set matches at the Clemson Classic, volleyball is back in action at the Wolfpack Invitational on Friday and Saturday against Howard, North Carolina State, and Coastal Carolina. Desi Kuleva led the way at the Clemson Classic, averaging more than 15 kills per match, including a career-high 20 versus Wofford. Women's tennis opens its fall season by hosting the 22nd annual Tribe Invitational as part of Family Weekend at the college. The three-day event will be held at the Millie West Tennis Facility, the Commons Courts, and McCormick Negelson Tennis Center, beginning at 9:15 a.m. each day. This is Laurel Jacques with Tribe Sports Today. Back to Andrew with more on the Tribe.
Thanks, Laurel. Now on to men's soccer, who returns home after a two-match road trip when they take on number 3 North Carolina right here at Martin Family Stadium. The match, which carries a 7 p.m. kickoff time, will be broadcast nationally on the NSCA TV and can be seen locally in Hampton Roads on Cox Channel 110. William & Mary closes out the week against another top 10 foe in Georgetown on Sunday at 4 p.m. in D.C. The Tribe football team returned to Zabel Stadium and picked up a 29-14 victory over in-state rival Norfolk State on Saturday night. The football team returns back to Zabel Stadium this weekend when they'll host Lafayette as part of Family Weekend. The 7 p.m. kickoff will be streamed for free in HD live on Tribe Athletics TV. That does it for another exciting edition of Tribe Sports Today. Remember to follow us on all of our social media sites, and for stats, stories, features, and much, much more, visit tribeathletics.com. For Laurel Jock, I'm Andrew Phillips. We'll see you next time.
The Tribe Club, essential for excellence.